and welcome back to HP How To For You. I'm Steph, and this is Bill, and every 2 weeks we bring you tips, tricks, and how-to information based on what you want to hear about for your HP products.
And today we're going to talk about a question that we get a lot.
A lot.
What do I do if I forgot my password?
That's right. We get this question all the time, and it can be pretty frustrating. So what do we do?
Well, there's a few things to keep in mind. The first thing is to figure out what type of an account that you have. Is it a Microsoft account, or is it a local PC account?
Well, how do you know what type you have?
Well, if you log on to your PC using an email address, you probably have a Microsoft connected account. If you log on with a username or your name, you probably have a local account. This is the first step because password recovery methods are different depending on which type of account you have.
Okay, that makes sense. So let's say that I have a Microsoft connected account. What do I do?
That's really easy because when you have a Microsoft connected account, you're going to need access to the internet on a different device, like a phone or a tablet or another PC.
Like a friend's PC?
Right.
Cool.
And not the one that you locked yourself out of.
That makes sense.
All right. So let's go ahead and show you how to do this. So you're going to need to go to account.live.com/password/reset. And that'll take you through the reset process. And you're going to want to click on I forgot my password, and then click reset your password. It's going to send you a secondary authentication method. And what that is if you set up a secondary email address or you set up your phone as your secondary option, it'll either send you an email or a text message with a code in it, and that's your authentication code to reset your password with. And that's it.
That looks pretty simple. What do I do if I have a local account?
Now, if you have a local account, I recommend that you prepare before you forget your password by creating a password recovery disk. And that's really simple. What you want to do is just click on the start menu and type in password. And what that will give you is a list of options, and one of those options is create a password reset disk. Follow the prompts on the screen and create that password reset disk.
Okay, so I have a local account. I've forgotten my password, but I do have a recovery disk.
Excellent. All you'll need to do is insert the recovery disk, the password recovery disk, when you're prompted, and then follow the steps on the screen to reset your password.
And once I've done that, then I'll be able to sign in with my new password?
Yep, absolutely.
Okay. So, what do I do if I've forgotten my password? I have a local account, but I did not make a recovery disk. I would never do that, but a friend of a friend did, and they're wondering how to get back into their PC.
Sure. Mm-hmm. You have one other option.
Okay.
To do this, you need an account on that same PC that has administrative privileges, which means you can log into that account and then change the password on the account that you're locked out of. Now, to do that, you'll need to go into the PC, log in as the administrator, go into user accounts, and then manage that other user account and change the password. Then you can log in with the new password.
Perfect.
Easy.
Easy. All right, so you've shared with us how to reset a forgotten sign-in password. Do you have any tips for creating a strong password? I mean, what kind of password should I use now?
So, it's a really good question, and a lot of people ask that. A really good, strong password is at least 8 characters, and it contains capitals and lowercase letters. It contains numbers and symbols, and you should avoid using complete names or phrases like Bill is not a good password.
Bill is not a good password.
No.
So I probably need to change my password.
Okay, yeah, you might want to do that.
So then what are some good alternatives to Bill? Theoretically speaking, because of course I would never use the name Bill as my password.
Well, you could use some acronyms, or you could replace letters with numbers or symbols, and that would help make it a little more difficult for people to guess.
So instead of just Bill, which I would never use, let's go with an acronym, and I will use symbols and numbers in place of letters.
Great, let's do that.
All right.
Change password.
Changing my password. Let's go with Bill is my man crush Monday. Or how about Bill's number one fan? Or maybe Bill is my hero. Or we could always use your birthday, Jay.
Hey. That's enough. We can stick, you can change it later. Those are all really good examples of passwords, except for your birthday. Don't use your birthday. That's not good. I think that's a wrap for today.
Yes, I think you're probably right. Please follow us on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/howtoforyou, or you can find us on the HP support forum at
hp.com/support forum.
You can find us there under the blog section. Leave us a comment, let us know what you want to hear about in future episodes, and we'll talk to you guys later.
See you guys.
Awkward!
Awkward. Really awkward. Bill is my man. Where did you come up with these?
That's all Jamie.
'Cause this is not a local account. To make the password hard to guess and hard to remember.
All right, that's a wrap for today.
Oh, I forgot that.